pleasure to be here presenting Noé Bárcenas from the Center of Mathematics in Morelia, UNAM, and he's going to talk about computational methods for twisted KO theory.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you to everybody for being here, and it's a great pleasure to be here honoring the memory of Professor Kittler. And I was thinking, what will be a nicer way of honoring Sam Kittler's memory other than doing a nice computation in classical algebra in Tuhoe. So this is a report on ongoing work, basically with Michael Joachim from the University of Münster in Germany and Rudolf Zeidler based in Göttingen. And it's about computational methods for twisted KO theory. Well, let me very briefly introduce what real K-theory or KO theory is. Well, KO theory is a generalized cohomology theory. And for having a very concrete way of thinking of about KO theory, it's a cohomology theory, and the zeroth group is just the Grothendieck ring of isomorphism classes of real vector bundles over a compact CW complex to fix ideas. And well, there are other groups. Let me introduce first the negative ones. So giving a positive integer, I will introduce the negative KO theory graded in that integer just as the kernel of the projection map of X times the n-dimensional sphere to X. And then fundamental results due to both give us that this cohomology theory is aperiodic. Let me, you have this this shift, KON is the same as KON plus 8 of X. And here are the coefficients. So 0 is the integers. It's just the evaluation at X equals a point. At 1, there is sigma 2. At minus 2 is sigma 2. Dimension minus 4, it's a copy of the integers, and there is a periodicity phenomenon going on here. And for the sake of completeness, let me just give some examples of these generators. So the Atiyah-Bott-Shapiro method, which is a nice interaction between the theory of Clifford algebras, index theory, and this KO theory, gives us exactly the generators we want. So there is a map of modules over the Clifford algebra C2 and C1. This is just tensoring with the first Clifford algebra. And then this alpha construction, which is actually an index theoretical construction in nature, gives us the generator in degree minus 1. It's going to be called eta. There is an alpha also of constructed with ungraded Clifford algebras here. And this index theoretical way of constructing the Atiyah-Bott-Shapiro construction gives us the generator in degree 4. And in an analogous way, the periodicity operator, the Bott class in degree minus 3. This is an instance of a general phenomenon of analytical nature, namely the fact that this real K-theory is the recipient for indices of real operators. And this is explained here. So given a smooth spin manifold and an elliptic Clifford linear differential operator acting on the section of a bundle, which is a module over the Clifford algebra in Greek A, then the symbol is in a very natural way an element in this KO minus K of the cotangent bundle, which is isomorphic to the tangent bundle. And then a push-forward homomorphism gives us the possibility to define the Clifford index, which lands in the coefficients we just defined in the slide before. So this is what KO theory is. So this is a cohomology theory, which captures a lot of interesting analytical constructions of manifolds with real operators. So in this talk, we are aiming to describe a generalization of this theory to the so-called twisted context. And let me just introduce what do I mean by twisted. Well, cohomology theories, generalized ones like the KO theory. And to fix idea, let me suppose that this cohomology theory comes from a highly structured ring spectrum, like orthogonal spectra or symmetric spectra to fix ideas. Well, they have the notion of an orientation for an n-dimensional manifold. And there is an obstruction to decide whether a manifold is orientable or not in the space of twistings, which is this GLM1. There is a dual version for this cohomology theory, and there is a lot of pairings, like the Poincaré duality pairing, making a slant product with the fundamental class for the manifold, or intersection pairings, which code all the axiomatics of Poincaré duality. Let me put this in a concrete example. So consider the Eilenberg-MacLane spectra, and this is just ordinary cohomology. Well, the orientation of an n-dimensional manifold is just a non-zero class in this top dimensional homology group with the integral coefficients. The obstruction to do this is just the first Tiefel-Whitney class with CMOD2 coefficients. And the homotopy type of this space of twistings, I just consider the pi naught of it for the moment, is just CMOD2. And the twistings of this theory, they are in correspondence with a homomorphism of the fundamental group to the CMOD2, which is via the Hurevich homomorphism, just homomorphism of the abelianization, which is the first homology group. And by means of universal coefficient theorem, you can identify this home of the homology to H1 with integer with CMOD2 coefficients. So the obstructions for orientations, they lie here. And the twisted version of ordinary cohomology is just so-called cohomology with local coefficients. So given a twisting here, which is just a map from a homomorphism from the fundamental group to CMOD2, so-called orientation character, then the twisted cohomology groups are just the cohomology groups of the chain complex of the universal cover of the manifold. Here are the integers together with this action of the fundamental group. And then I consider the co-chain complex with these coefficients, universal cover, and this is the integers with the twisted action. And a crucial idea, which will be the key for the computations we are going to do, is that the natural transformation of such twisted ordinary cohomology with coefficients in CP modes, just ordinary twisted cohomology, are described by certain twisted spiral squares. And describing these operations for the first time, it was the content of Professor Sam Kittler's PhD thesis in 1963. So this way of thinking is going to be crucial in the computations we are doing. Well, let me go over to the twisted K-theory. So the real K-theory admits a model via orthogonal spectra, right? This is due to Michael Joachim. It was done in 2001, I guess. And here's the theorem. So the space of twistings, the BGL, KO is now a ring spectrum with respect to orthogonal in the model of orthogonal spectrum. And this KO, it has the homotopy type of the Eilenberg-MacLane space for CMOD2 in degree 1. And the Eilenberg-MacLane of, this is a typo, sorry, this is CMOD2 in 2. So the space of twistings is a product of Eilenberg-MacLane spaces, both of type CMOD2 in degree 1 and degree 2. And I will call the homotopy class of a map into space X to this spectrum a full twisting, right? And then we construct the twisted KO theory groups as the homotopy groups of a space of sections of a bundle with fiber the KO spectrum. So this twisting in K semo 2-1 and semo 2-2, it's just the local gluing data for constructing a principal bundle over the space, and now I take just the associated bundle with fiber the KO spaces of the space. Right?
Sir, what does gamma E W?
This is just space of sections, and this is a EW is a principal bundle you construct out of the twisting data, and KO is just the spectrum. So this is just the space of sections of a fiber bundle with fiber the corresponding KO space, and I construct it with the principal bundle which comes from the twisting, right? Well, here is the main theorem of today. Take a CW complex, and then I will denote by W1 the a class in H1 in cohomology, first cohomology with integer with CMO2 coefficients, and W2 in the second cohomology with CMO2 coefficients. And this is reminiscence of thinking of these classes as the obstruction classes for being orientable and spin, right, for a manifold. And then the full twisting is just the product in this product of cohomology groups. Here's the theorem. So the theorem is there is a spectral sequence which converges to twisted KO theory, and the E2 term is just the following, is just a check cohomology group of X in degree P, E2P, and the groups by minus Q of KO, the ones we had before, but now twisted. And this is twisted check cohomology groups, right? So there's a spectral sequence for twisted KO theory with this E2 term, and now we are going to describe the first differentials. So differentials are of the following form. So we have, ¿podría prender la luz, por favor? So this is a spectral sequence for KO theory. And as you remember, KO theory has a very nice periodicity pattern. So this, the coefficients in degree the coefficients in degree zero, these are just the integers, in degree minus one, this is CMO2, in degree minus two, this is CMO2, in degree three, there are just zeros, which I am going to draw, in degree four, this is minus four, this is just a C, and four stages downwards, there is another C coming from the minus eight class. So there are differentials over there. So you can draw a very nice D2 differential going from CMO2. Let me just put here, there's another CMO2. CMO2. Zero C. So this is a differential which goes from C from a zero line, which is just an eight D, and it goes it goes just one like this and two to the right. This is over there, And what can it be? So you think for it with a moment. It may be a square two. So, sorry, this is a going to two to the up and one to the right. It would be a square two over there. With composed with restriction. It may be as well a cup product with the first Stephen Whitney class, the only one. This is just something in degree one, cup with a square one with restriction. It may be as well cup with W1 to the square, but it may be as well cup with the W2. And the theorem is that all these operations appear at non-zero and appear in spaces which we are going to catch. The second type of D2, this is something which goes from C-mod 2 to C-mod 2. And this may be square 2 or cup. We don't have to reduce like here, or maybe it can be the first W1 with square 1, W1 to the square, or W2, very similar. And there are D3 differentials which go from C-mod 2 to C. And these are given by Bochsteins of square 2, so called square 3, and cup with Bochstein of the second, the class in degree 2. So the theorem is there is a spectral sequence with E2 term like this, and the differentials are given exactly in this formula. Here's the sketch of the proof. So how do we prove this? First, we use the Siegel's cover method for the filtration. Rein-Siegel, in one of his first papers, discovered a method to construct of a cover for a space, a spectral sequence. This is just doing by using the filtration on the nerve. The realization of the cover, and then the general method gives us a way of obtaining graded models, and then we have to identify the E2 term with of a spectral sequence of cohomology groups of check type with Dalembert-MacLane spectral cohomology. This is very very natural and documented in the literature, and then this is something crucial for the time when Samuel Dittler made this crucial development, and it's the fact that Brown representability does not only tell us that that the cohomology groups are representable, but rather that also the natural stable transformation between them are representable. And this is the key idea of a lot of computations with the distributed algebra, realizing natural transformation between cohomology theories as non-zero maps, interesting maps over there. So we do this. This goes over even to the parametrized setting, to spectra with a map to another spectra, which is exactly the data we need to construct twisted KO or twisted K theories in general. And then we just have to catch up the differential explicitly in examples, which are of a very nice and fundamental nature. And I recommend this for graduate students in algebraic topology. This is a lot of interesting spaces, examples, and relations you have to have in mind. So this is, let me show you one of these identifications. So consider the canonical line bundle over RB infinity, right? So this is just a tautological bundle over RP infinity. And then I will consider the first Stephen Whitney class, right, of this bundle. I will consider as next the bundle given by adding up two times, right? So this is the two, the copy of two times this eta. And then you compute the Stephen Whitney classes of this bundle, and the first Stephen Whitney class of this bundle is just the W1 to the square. This is just elementary computation over there in the mod 2 cohomology ring of RP infinity. And then this is the key. Our twisted chaos theory comes with a nice twisted Thom isomorphism. So there is an identification of the KO of the KO groups of a bundle of a base space twisted with a class with the KO groups untwisted ones now of the Thom space. Right? This is a Thom isomorphism now interpreted in the twisting setting. And then the Thom space of this bundle is just this stunted projective space, RP infinity minus 2 modulo RP infinity minus 1. So now our computation of twisted KO theory of RP infinity with respect to this class reduces just to compute the untwisted KO theory group of this stunted projective space. And this is a computation which is basic for a Goulson algebraic topology. So directly from the Atiyah-Hilzebruch spectral sequence, you can just read everything. Because the as you know, the map of the subspace homomorphic to this into the RP over there, it's injective in homology, and then you just cut off all the classes which are in lower degrees. So, and it looks like this. So squares are copies of the integers, and these dots are just copies of CMOD2. And then the only possible differentials are a D2 going over there, like this, from degree 0 to degree 2. And this is in the untwisted KO theory of the stunted projective space. So this is a differential of type D2. And this differential is just what can you construct, which goes two degrees up in CMOD2 cohomology. It's just square 2. There's no other thing you can construct over that. And then via the Thom isomorphism, you interpret this as just square 2 plus W1 to the square. So the Thom isomorphism goes over very natural to the E2 term of the spectral sequences, and you get the differentials by just copying with the twisting class, which is in this case W1 to the square. And then just from the Atiyah-Hilzebruch spectral sequence, you compute this, and then the twisted K theory groups are just like this. So this is a copy of set, the two periodicals. This goes over to 4, and this is degree 6, and they are shifted by 2, as you can see from here, and they go over to these results. So the moral for this is use first the filtration to construct a twisted Atiyah-Hilzebruch spectral sequence, use the Thom isomorphism to construct an untwisted one, and then reinterpret a lot of very known computations of KO theory of stunted projective spaces as now computations of twisted KO theory. I mean, for the expert in the audience, the computations of K theory, real or complex, stunted projective spaces are classical. They come from the 60s, done mainly by a lot of Japanese mathematicians, and they are actually computations of twisted KO theory, or twisted KO theory via this method.
about further computational results. Well, we just catch up with RP infinity because it's sort of the first interesting space you construct in for having examples in algebraic topology. And there's a very nice relation to standard projective spaces via this Tom isomorphism. And we just realized that doing the computations for RP infinity was mainly the only kind of arguments we needed to compute the twisted chaos theory of all classifying spaces of cyclic groups of even order. Because the two terms of this of these two groups is just the twisted cohomology groups for this group, for all the possible twistings, and these groups are known to have the same cohomology for all n. This is just a tensor of exterior algebra and a polynomial algebra, and it's very very well documented in the literature and used by people working on the Gromov-Lawson-Rosenberg conjecture, mainly Bobini, Gilkey, and Stotz. So, and this takes us to the connection we are going to establish. So this is a computational result, which is just computing KO theory of classifying spaces of groups. And let me put this in a broader context. So there's a conjecture, the Gromov-Lawson-Rosenberg conjecture, stating fundamental obstructions for a string manifold with a given fundamental group to have a metric of positive scalar curvature. And the Gromov-Lawson-Rosenberg conjecture predicts that there is an invariant for this for a manifold with this fundamental group to admit a metric of positive scalar curvature. And the obstruction is the so-called alpha invariant, which is the following. Here you have the n Bordesian group spin Bordesian group of the classifying space. There is a map which is the alpha invariant, which goes over to the connective KO theory, composed with the periodicity map from KO theory to the periodic K theory, and on the last part the assembly map, the real Baumkorn assembly map for the group G, which lands on the reduced sister algebra, real sister algebra of the group G. And the Gromov-Lawson-Rosenberg conjecture predicts that this is the only invariant which to the existence of a metric of positive scalar curvature. There are counterexamples for this conjecture realized by Thomas Schick, but the main belief among the people working in this area of interaction of differential geometry and algebraic topology is that this conjecture is true at least for finite groups. So our aim now is to interpret our computational results on twisted periodic KO theory within this context. Let me show you how is this going to work. Let me explain a bit. The KO theory is the connective version, and the computations of connective K theory and connective real K theory are typically more involved. They are typically done using the AND spectral sequence, and there is a whole book of Bob Brunner and John Greenlees describing how to do such computations. Nowadays, there are twisted versions of twisted spin or non-spin Bordesian, twisted KO, we described it very briefly, and the twisted KO theory. And there are quite explicit methods to compute a lot of information in the periodic case, which tends to be easier, which we just displayed here. And it basically reduces what an advanced student of master's in algebraic topology should know, namely what RP infinity is, what the Stiefel-Whitney classes are, what is the relation to stunted projective spaces. They're quite elementary arguments over there. What we are going to do next is to interpret, to perform computation with the Adams spectral sequence to this part in the twisted case, and using the twisted Stiefel algebra, which was first examined in Sam Gittler's PhD thesis in a fundamental way. And how is this going to work? Well, there is this spin Bordism group, twisted one, with the two data. They also come from spin Bordism of the classifying space. This is a twisted homology theorem. Now you have here the connected version, also twisted one, and the periodic over there, the periodic version of KO theory for BG, and the twisted assembly map, which now goes over to a twisted version of the sister algebra, which is not a surprise, it's just the sister algebra of a certain extension of the group. And fundamental results of Heberstreit and Joachim describe that the spin Bordism ring, so putting here just a point, is determined as in the case, very well known by Brown-Peterson, by Stiefel-Whitney classes and Potterian classes. So the result is that the twisted spin Bordism is determined just by what the Stiefel-Whitney and classes they go over, and a certain generalization of twisted Potterian classes, which they construct in a paper on the archive. So there are computations here, like telling us that the spin Bordism group is just determined by that. Our results here are done for KO theory, but the duality, the fundamental.
Do you mean the K theory of the sister algebra, or
over there is the K theory of the sister algebra. Here over is just the K theory of the classifying space.
But there is the missing K, or is just your notation?
It's K. There is missing K, right? Okay. It's K. It's real KO. It's K theory for real sister algebras. Our computations are here, and by a Poincaré duality, our computations are actually KO upper, but by a Poincaré duality they are KO lower, very well interpreted. And the part which is missing and we are going to develop is to compute over here things in the connective KO theory of the classifying space of the group, of this kind of groups, with basically with the Adams spectral sequence. And well, the result is going to give positive evidence for the validity of the twisted conjecture for this class of groups. Okay, so this is what I wanted to tell you. Thank you very much to everybody.
Complex K theory has gotten a lot of attention in the last 6 or 7 years, primarily because of the work of Fried, Hopkins, and Telemann relating it to the Verlinde algebra and representation of loop groups and that sort of thing. Is there anything analogous to twisted real K theory?
Yeah, let me give you two answers to these questions. Actually, we with a team of collaborators in the complex case, we managed to relate certain multiplicative structures on the twisted K homology of a complex one to multiplicative products on the sister algebra. So in a way, the fundamental work of Fried, Hopkins, and Telemann has to do with the Van Coot conjecture. So this is the content of a paper of myself with Mario Velázquez and Paulo Carrillo, which we prove that the kind of multiplicative structures you find in the twisted K theory, like Fried, Hopkins, and Telemann, do have to do with the Van Coot assembly map. So there is a way of bringing them together.
So their work had to do with an equivariant version of twisted K-theory for a
for the group acting on itself by conjugation.
Yeah, so, so is that what's happening?
So you can also construct the twisted K homology and dualize this and take over the multiplicative structure of the K-theory, dualize, go through assembly, and then the theorem is that the multiplicative structure you have from Feldkoppings and Telemann over there, which is one, it's very mysterious because it doesn't mix twists, goes over through this map to the left hand side of the Baumkorn assembly map. So this is the theorem we prove in that paper. Even for non-compact D-groups. So you can complete the part which is missing, so to speak, in the Hopkins Telemann by an assembly map over there. And then we interpret this product as a product which is intimately related to the Baumkorn conjecture. And in the real case, there is a lot of similar products on the real KO theory, which we expect to have to do with that, but we still haven't explored that. So in resuming, so there's a deep connection, and the deep connection is that it is related by the Baumkorn assembly map, which in case of being an isomorphism, it's going to be a ring isomorphism. And this is something which the Baumkorn people really didn't know before. So that's my answer.
Can I add something to your answer? Really, there is a PhD student's thesis who's working on a generalization the same way that you say for the KR theory.
For KR theory?
KR theory of G acting on itself by conjugation.
For compact loops.
For compact loops. And I believe that he obtains similar results.
So this was for a finite group? Or?
This is just for finite groups.
This is and what stops you from a discrete group?
What is what? I mean, the computations are very, very easy groups. Like,